from the underground.
Hi, and welcome back to Animal Liberation TV. So, now I'm back on the videos, I'm kind of getting on with Badger's episodes, finally. I was going to do which is all about my personal experiences through activisms and campaigning and my interactions with police, which has been plenty, and all my prison stories, of which there's a lot. You know, I'm quite well known for my police and prison stories. My son's heard them all as he grows up. If I start telling one sometimes at a social occasion, now he's 29, he'll go, "Oh no, not this one again, Max." So some of you haven't heard them, so I've got new victims. So I was going to do the first episode about how I got involved in animal rights, basically through Hunt Savage, properly. But I thought I'd do something a bit more exciting and kind of show you the highest and the lowest point, so to speak, in it all, which I've also been mentioning a few times in my podcast, which was my involvement with the Manchester conspiracy case, which is basically a court case that happened in the early and mid-90s in Manchester, where there was a lot of ALF actions going on. And in fact, podcast number 2, the ALF response to the murder of Mike Hill, really you should watch that before you watch this series, because what this is all from that time. It was us that they targeted in Manchester after the murder of Mike Hill. So there was a huge wave of action, and basically I got caught up in that and all the things that came out of it. So all the prison stories you're going to hear are resulting from this court case in Manchester, where there were 10 of us on a big conspiracy trial to commit criminal damage over something like 9 months in 6 counties in the northwest of England, where there was huge levels of ALF activities going on. and so all my prison stories come from that. I was arrested in August 91 and my probation finished at the end of 96. So 5 years of my life was taken up with this Manchester conspiracy case and all the ins and outs of it, which you'll hear in. I'll try and go through everything in a chronological scale so you hear the full stories and how it all transpired, and my angle on it, at least. And what I can remember as well, because it's 30 years ago now. And I went in and out 3 times on that sentence, so including 2 remand sessions in Young Offenders. So I've got a lot of stories going on with that. So I thought to kind of highlight and maybe grab your interest in a little bit, I'd read out some newspaper articles after we were sent down. Okay, so this is, where's this one? Express, I think this is Ultranum or something like that. Sale and Ultranum Express, I think. It's 2 parts of South Manchester. Conviction of fanatic unleashes new fury. Animals! They are terrorists in the same way as the IRA. This is an obsession with these people. So those guys must be MPs or something. Animals. I'm happy to be called an animal. I mean, it's what we all are. That's part of the problem, isn't it? Humans think they're not animals. The animal rights terrorists who targeted charity shops in Ultranum, Hale and Simply are no better than the IRA, it was claimed this week. Well, the IRA... Anyway, let's not start and get into that. Fury greeted the conviction of Ultranum ex-soldier John Morgan, who was one of the 10 of us on trial, for his part in a reign of terror which caused £15,000 worth of damage to 27 shops in just one night. Well, they've got the wrong John there. Well, there are actually 3 Johns in the Manchester conspiracy case. But they've got the wrong John, that's not even what he got done for, that's what we got done for, 3 of us, separate from John, so they've got the facts completely wrong. Morgan 34 from Moss Lane was part of a highly organised hit squad which caused the deaths of countless animals who were unable to cope with the wild after they're released by the gang. They always say that. Every wildlife liberation I've ever seen, which been a few, you know, covered by the media, they always say that they die. They always say that. On Monday, he was sentenced to 6 months suspended jail term by Mr. Justice Elliot at Manchester Crown Court. Justice Elliot, he's the guy that gave me 3 years. I told him he was a wig-wearing wanker when he gave me my sentence. And I called him a few other things across the courtroom as well. I hated that guy. I still, you know, I don't know if he's alive or not. I hate that guy. Five others were jailed for a total of 13 years, and one more was conditionally discharged. Morgan wasn't at home for comment. The fanatics, all members of the Animal Liberation Front, attacked cancer research, fish and chip and angling shops in Auchtrinham, Hale and Simperley, causing during a spate of attacks which caused £40,000 damage in the north of England. £40,000 damage. £40,000 damage was basically what happened in one night during those periods. Tory councillor Patrick, Tory councillor Patrick Mayers told the Express, "They are terrorists. I have some sympathy with their aims, but this is an obsession with these people." And it becomes the same obsession as we have with groups like the IRA. What the fuck? Just like the IRA, they begin to lose sight of what they are actually doing. I don't think so, mate. They are terrorists and they should be treated as such. What? There's no logic or intelligence to these people, are they? Scum. Fellow Tory councillor, Roy Godwin said, "They're terrorists in the same way as the IRA terrorists." Oh my God, he's just repeating the same. Where they sat next to each other, just repeating each other like posh parrots. Posh parrot pedos, which they probably are. "People have a right to believe what they will, but they don't have the right to force it on others." This is a thing when people say animal rights, people are fascists because we're imposing our views and worlds on others. No, you're being human imperialists, imposing your will on animals in through speciesism and the actual practice of eating meat and dairy and all the rest of it, and wearing the shit, and you know, going to circuses and zoos and blah blah blah, you know, and supporting pharmaceutical twats. In sentencing the gang, Mr. Justice Alex said, "It was a deadly campaign fired by the single issue of fanaticism." God, I hated Judge Elliot, what a twat. Hang the judges, as they say in the Clash songs. You know, fuck off. A deadly campaign. Deadly. How can it be deadly? No one was hurt at all. Well, and that's a judge saying that. You know, do you not even know basic English? We've got another one. Activists jailed. We've got a picture of three of the people, three of the ten of us. There's, whoops, it's all back to front here. There's Al, Terry Helsby, and Fran, as we call him, John Morgan, they call him here. And Terry was one of the people, along with John Curtin, who I mentioned in my ALF News Cuttings 2 about the Hunt Retribution Squad. He was one of the two people jailed for 2 years for trying to dig up the Duke of Beaufort in a publicity stunt. As part of the Hunt Retribution Squad, and I lived with Terry. Animal rights sell in terror campaign. Animal rights fanatics left a trail of death and destruction as they waged, I mean, that gives such a false headline, death and destruction, like we've gone around killing people. But they're going to say it's the animals that were let out and didn't survive, blah, 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 yawn. Left a trail of death and destruction as they waged a terror campaign throughout the north of England. The highly obsessed hit squads targeted a zoo, a poultry farm, butchers and cancer research shops in a bid to sabotage the meat industry and free animals. Well, if you watch podcast 2, the ALF response to the murder of Mike Hill, I read out the action list in that and you'll know that it's a lot more than that. A lot more. For example, in Manchester alone, 1,000 windows were broken in that 9 months. In Liverpool and the other towns in the northwest, about another 1,000. And probably in the rest of the north of England, about another 500 or 1,000. So there's about 2,500 to 3,000 shop windows were smashed in 9 months. You know, and they're just picking out the odd little thing. It was a deadly campaign fired by the single issue of fanaticism, said John Jolly. He then imposed jail terms totalling more than 13 years on five members of an animal rights cell who operated from Wally Range, while two others, including Ultimate Man, walked free. Mr. Anthony G. QC, who I mentioned had, when they finally caught Keith, gave him the 14 years prosecuting, said all the defendants were members of the Animal Liberation Front waging a campaign of damage on businesses. Their targets included chemists, butchers, bookmakers, leather shops and charities. The aim of the group was to cause maximum economic damage, and when businesses were hit, their insurance premiums rocketed. Attacks were premeditated and carefully planned by extremists wearing flak jackets, balaclavas and armed with high-powered catapults known as the Black Widows. I did love my Black Widow. we were best friends for a while there. They also carried bolt cutters, wire croppers, and the campaign caused about £40,000 worth of damage throughout Great Manchester, Merseyside and Derbyshire. £40,000, no. I mean, I guess I'd have to say at least £10 million damage was caused. One night, members of the group left a trail of damage amounting to £15,000 when windows were broken at 27 premises, including fishing tackle shops, fish and chip shops, and two cancer research shops in Altrincham, Hale, Timpley and Chorlton. So that was me, John and Claire, who got done for that. Three of us got done for that in the car. I'll talk about all those juicy details in future episodes. The base for the gang was a house in Clarendon Road, Whalley Range, Manchester. The AALF cell was smashed following a large-scale undercover operation codenamed Lance. Mr. G said the leader of the gang, Keith Moran, they're saying basically, leader, every time makes me laugh, was arrested but has escaped from police custody. Go on, and that's the reason why, because we were probably, if we'd got done for the big Manchester conspiracy, we were probably all looking at between 5 and 10 years, most of us, and Keith, you know, like whatever, 20 or something. So Keith escaping meant that the whole trial collapsed because they built up this silly story for the big Manchester conspiracy, saying he was the leader and we were all kind of following him. And without him in custody, their story fell apart because they couldn't prosecute us as being followers of some sort of cult leader type guy if he's not even there. So he did us a huge favour by escaping as well as himself. In the dock were John Morgan, 34, of Altrincham, Terence Helsby, 30 of Clarendon Road, Whalley Range. Alison McKeon, 26, of Whalley Range. Rian Hopkin, who we know is Blood, age 24, of West Yorkshire. John Marnell, we used to call him John Taxi, he was my co-accused. 26, of Liverpool, and Claire Rush, 23, that was my girlfriend, the mother of my son. And Max Watson, age 22, both from Oxford. Helsby was jailed for 3 years and 6 months, Marnell and Watson for 3 years each, and Rush and McKeon for 2 years each. Morgan was given a 6-month suspended term, and Hopkins was conditionally discharged for a year. And then I'm going to read this bit out, undercover operation that led to arrests. 6 months of patient surveillance in Operation Lance led to the police cracking the Manchester cell of the Animal Liberation Front. Based in Manchester, the operation involved 50 officers from 6 forces, including Greater Manchester Police. Lance began in response to a spate of attacks on those involved in the meat industry. In total, 800 incidents were reported throughout the Northwest, which is generous of them to actually give a good figure. But like I say, in the Northwest, I'm saying 2,500 actions took place, roughly, I guess. The cell was tracked down to 211 Clarendon Road, Whalley Range, which is mine and Terry's flat. And that's the flat that they bugged for 6 months, which again I'm going to cover in future episodes because, yes, there's interesting stories around that bug. Known ALF activists from all over the country were seen to visit the house. Detective Superintendent Ivan Montgomery. People like that is why I've got that tattoo on my arm. You know what I mean? People like this twat. We looked at many people, but those were the ones that were most actively involved. There were others that crossed our path but weren't prosecuted. She's trying to make people that are still free a bit nervous about it. Right, and I am going to quickly squeeze this one in because this one's got quite a bit of interesting stuff on it. Terror of the Secret Army, which waged war on me. And then there's a picture of Terry and Blood, and then me, and then Al and Fran. That's 5 of us out of the 10 with the Manchester Conspiracy. Terror of the Secret Army, which waged war on meat. To the enemies, they are dismissed as the Veggie Army or mocked for their downbeat dress. In truth, they are deadly serious fanatics prepared to sacrifice their own freedom for the sake of all creatures, great and small. Today, seven members of an Animal Liberation Front cell face jail for a highly organised campaign of destruction they called economic sabotage. Using terrorist techniques, ALF hit squads caused destruction at any premises activists regarded as harmful to animals. That is true. We're kind of on one. The seven being sentenced today at Manchester Crown Court were involved in raids on a zoo and an egg farm and catapulted for bearing attacks on butchers and betting shops. Their raids occurred during 9 months of economic sabotage, which saw 800 attacks, again more like 2,500, attacks carried out in the north of England. Today's court appearance followed catapult attacks in shop windows in the south Manchester area, mainly Sale, Disbury and Chorlton. Police are still investigating arson abattoirs and meat wholesalers in the Oldham and Stockport areas. Overall damage was put about 1 million and included 25 arson attacks at abattoirs for which other ALF activists are being sought. Because no one got done for any of those arson attacks, all 25 of them. So they say £1 million damage and 25 arson attacks. Probably one or two of those arson attacks was £1 million each. So that's millions. 25 arson attacks is going to be millions and millions already. Secret. 50 detectives from the six forces formed a special squad based in Manchester, codenamed Operation Mount Yawn Yawn. They were operational 24 hours a day for 6 months. Yeah, spying on us in our flat, listening to us, you know, I don't know what, like having little parties, socialising, talking with your flatmate, having sex with your partner. They're listening to the whole thing. You know, dirty bastards. The activists in turn employed anti-surveillance strategy to avoid being followed or heard. We were on to them. The police discovered that ALF militants from all over the country were visiting a flat at Wally Range, Manchester, number 201. Oh, I love that flat. I mean, crazy times and kind of intense because we knew the police were watching us. Anyway, number 201 Connell Road became a key base for ALF attacks, and it is believed detectives followed some members on raids. It is believed the wave of attacks was triggered by the death of hunt saboteur Mike Hill, 18, who was run over by a trailer belonging to the Cheshire Beagles hunt. Yeah, well, they got that bit right anyway. Mike Hill became an ALF martyr, and the economic sabotage campaign began soon after his death in February 91. Betting shops were attacked and even fishing tackle outlets and premises carrying circus posters had windows shattered. Cancer research shops were attacked because ALF believed they were raising funds for animal experiments. Ball bearings were fired from high-powered catapult called Black Widow, which clamps to the arm for steady aim. Nice. The ALF raiders were all vegans, refusing to drink milk or eat animal products. They never wore silk or wool or leather shoes. I mean, that's, back then, vegans were like, what the fuck is a vegan? Back in the early 90s. And then the paper's a bit torn, I can't read it properly, but it kind of finishes a type of extreme criminality that we saw in these cases. They are usually well educated, well organised, and totally dedicated to their cause. We take their attacks very seriously indeed. Our investigations are ongoing.
Investigation, shut up.
So, anyway, how did it all come to that? What's the reality? What's the truth behind those stories? I'm going to go into all of that and then. I'll tell you about what happened when I got that 3-year prison sentence they mentioned there from lovely Judge Elliot. And I can tell you all the stories and things that I saw and happened to me in there, which I think you'll find interesting. So, in the meantime, as always, take care. Now I'ma turn it around, digging the clip, yo, and listen to the sound.